This Chem 1A lecture video deals with the topic of stoichiometry. It's a big word, and it's a little hard to pronounce, and sometimes intimidates first-year chemistry students. But it doesn't have to. We're going to use this concept to tackle some really big questions, but in very small bites. For now, our learning objective is simply to use stoichiometric ratios as a conversion factor to convert between amounts of reactants and products. This is central to solving problems involving chemical quantities. Now, we know that reactions between pure substances occur between the smallest indivisible parts, so either the molecules involved, or if we're dealing with a pure element, the atoms involved. And here we're showing in a symbolic and a microscopic depiction of a balanced chemical reaction between the compound methane and the element oxygen. From the image, you can clearly see that two molecules of the diatomic element oxygen are required to fully combust the one molecule of methane. In a practical sense, it's easier to describe amounts of substance in a reaction in terms of mass rather than counting out individual molecules. But luckily, we have already mastered the skill of using molecular weight as a conversion factor between the absolute number of particles and the amount of substance in terms of mass. So today we're building upon that knowledge and our ability to balance chemical equations to learn how to convert between amounts of reactants and amounts of products. So this will allow us to predict what types of yield we can get from a reaction, given the amount of starting materials. Can also allow us to determine how much we need of each reactant in order to get a complete reaction. And so we'll see this in a number of practice problems in this lesson and also in our synchronous lesson this week. The word stoichiometry comes from the ancient Greek of stoichion, meaning element, and metri, meaning measure. And so central to stoichiometry is the individual particles of matter, which we typically measure in terms of moles. So stoichiometry and all stoichiometric problems are going to be focused around determining the moles of the different players in the reaction. And what we're looking at here is a concept map that I made that shows the interconnection of so many different measures that we have in chemical reactions. And there's more on here than we've currently covered in the course, but I wanted to show you the whole picture. And as we go forward, I'm going to pull out the little pieces or those little bites that we're going to use to solve these big problems. So here's an example of a big problem. During photosynthesis, plants convert carbon dioxide from the air and water up from their roots into glucose and oxygen gas. Write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction. We will then use stoichiometry to answer the problem. Supposing that a particular plant consumes 37.8 grams of CO2 in 1 week, and assuming that there is more than enough water present to react with all the CO2, what mass of glucose in grams can the plant synthesize from that amount of CO2? So as I mentioned, we need to start by balancing out this chemical equation. So we'll take our words and turn them into reactants and products. So plants convert carbon dioxide, so carbon dioxide is a reactant, and water is also a reactant, into, so the products being this glucose and oxygen gas. And we're recalling that oxygen is a diatomic element, so we've got O2 as our gas. So we're balancing out this reaction. We want to start with an element that only appears once on either side of the reaction arrow. So we can choose carbon or hydrogen here. We'll start with carbon. So we have 6 carbons as a product, but only 1 as a reactant. So I'm going to add a 6 in front of there. Now looking at the hydrogens, we have 12 hydrogens in our product and only 2 in our reactant. So we'll throw a 6 on there as well to multiply out those hydrogens to 12. do a little accounting on our reactant side, we've got 6 carbons and 12 oxygens. Then we've got 12 hydrogens and 6 oxygens. We can cancel out our 6 carbons with glucose and our 12 hydrogens with glucose. Now on the product side, we're left with 6 oxygens and 2 oxygens. The 6 oxygens cancels out neatly with the ones from water, while the remaining O2 gas we can still throw a stoichiometric coefficient in front of. So I'm going to use that one to make up the difference in oxygens by throwing a 6 in front of that as well. So we now have the balanced chemical reaction. We want to revisit the problem. And when we see the problem, we want to tease out any numbers or units that we see in the problem. And we're going to sort those into numbers and units that are given versus what is actually being asked to be found. So the only quantity that's given is our amount of carbon dioxide. And so we write that down under the given category. And the question is asking us how much glucose, or C6H12O6, that the plant can make. So that is our find. Now again, central to all stoichiometry problems is the concept of the balanced chemical equation and moles. So the first thing you want to have in your mind when you're approaching one of these problems is how can I take the given quantities and convert those to moles in the easiest way. So the way we would do that is with the molecular weight. So the molecular weight of carbon dioxide, we've got 1 carbon and 2 oxygens. So the molecular weight is going to be equal to 12 grams per mole for every carbon and 16 grams per mole for every oxygen. So 32 plus 12, we have 44 grams per mole for carbon dioxide. 37.8 grams of carbon dioxide times, what do we want to do? We want moles and we want to get rid of grams. So moles on the top, grams on the bottom, and that will give us the moles of CO2. The next step is to convert between the reactant that we're given. So the material in the equation, we're going from CO2, and our find is speaking of a different participant. It's talking about the glucose. So now that we're at moles, we can use our balanced equation to convert between the reaction participants. So we would have our answer from step one, which was our moles of CO2. And we're going to use the relationship of 6 CO2s for every 1 glucose as our conversion factor. So for every 1 mole of glucose that's going to be produced, we consume 6 moles of CO2. So when you're writing out your work in these problems, it's important not only to show your units, but also to show the material that those units apply to. So when I cancel, I'm not just canceling moles, I'm canceling moles of CO2. And so my answer will be in terms of moles of glucose. Now we have the correct material. We're again looking at what we're being asked to find. And it's not asking us for moles of glucose, it's asking us for grams of glucose. So our last step is to convert to the units asked for in the question. Taking our answer from step two, which was the moles of glucose, we know that we can convert between moles and mass in grams using the molecular weight. The molecular weight of glucose happens to be 180 grams per mole. So again, thinking about that as a conversion factor, where in moles we want grams, so we're going to put the 180 grams of glucose on top and 1 mole of glucose on the bottom. And then going forward, canceling out moles of glucose, we're left with an answer in terms of grams of glucose. Putting it all together, taking a snapshot from that earlier slide with the concept map, what we've done is we've connected the mass of one material, the CO2, to its molar amount using the molecular weight. Then we use the molar ratio from our balanced chemical equation to convert between one type of material in the reaction and another type of material. Now we can use this as per this example where we're converting between reactants and products, or it can be between two reactants or two products or any quantity within the balanced chemical reaction. Finally, we looked at what the question was asking for us in terms of units, and it was the mass of the glucose, and so we used the molecular weight of glucose. We can string all these steps together in one giant mathematical equation, and you'll find the answer is 25.8 grams. Now it's your turn to test the skills you've learned by doing your reading on this unit and watching this video. So at the bottom of your notes for today, try out this problem. How many moles of hydrogen gas are required to react with 86.3 grams of nitrogen monoxide following the reaction given below? So we have the equation already balanced for you, and this question's a little simpler because it's just asking for moles of hydrogen gas. So lay it out as we did in the previous example, and if you get an answer somewhere around 7 moles, you're doing a great job. All right, good luck and see you next time.